I'm Dave Wallin. I'm a professor at Western Washington University in Environmental Sciences, and we're here today doing a UAV survey, unmanned aircraft survey for elk in the Skagit Valley. We're testing out this new technology to see if it works for doing elk surveys. In the area we're covering, there are probably 200-400 elk, and we have about a dozen radio tagged elk out here. During the surveys, we're trying to see how many elk we can see, and at the same time we're keeping track of the location of all those radio tagged animals. WDFW every year does population surveys using manned helicopters, and we're trying to see if these unmanned aircraft might be a way of either supplementing or possibly in several years down the road, possibly even replacing the manned helicopter surveys. This could be a much less expensive and also certainly a safer way of doing the surveys. Unmanned aircraft have a public relations issue right now. There's a lot of concerns about privacy issues. And so we're part of the point of doing these surveys is to, at least today, is to try to demystify that and get the word out and illustrate that this technology has a lot of really interesting positive uses. The folks who are actually brought the equipment and actually doing the surveys are USGS and BLM personnel. And there's a UAS office in Denver. And they're specifically charged with and funded to use UAVs to evaluate the potential usefulness of UAVs to address a wide variety of different science questions. And so this is one of those test projects to see how it works. We got a student technology fund proposal funded last year to acquire some UAVs. We've already acquired a quadcopter, and we just recently ordered a couple of fixed-wing aircraft, similar to the ones that are being used here. So we're really excited to be able to use those for teaching and research. Hopefully, Western students can be on the sort of leading edge and helping to adopt this technology early on. And we're hoping that we'll be able to train students so that they'll be some of the first ones out of the box ready to use this technology. Certainly, it'd be easier to wait 2 or 3 years, but then we'd be behind the curve, and we'd like to be ahead of the curve.